आफ्टरनून मैम। गुड
आफ्टरनून।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
यस मैम। गुड आफ्टरनून मैम।
Which class did you all complete now? Just before this?
English.
Hindi class?
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
Oh, yeah. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
See, children, today our class is only for half an hour because you are having geography class at 1 o'clock. Okay, so the geography teacher will start the meeting at 1:15. So max to max by 1 o'clock, I leave.
Ma'am, but the next class starts at 1:30, no, ma'am? It's 1:30 to 2 o'clock.
No,
it's one.
Based upon the availability of the geography teacher, today the class has been scheduled at 1 o'clock. I think you all have saw the invite.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, go through the invite. The geography class, some Urmila ma'am, she's taking, right? It will be at 1 o'clock. So it will start at 1:10 or 1:15. So we'll have a small topic today and we'll wind up the class because she's from other school. So we have to give her time. Okay, so as you all know, we are discussing the chapter chemical reactions. In that, we have completed first type of chemical reaction is direct combination reaction, in which two elements or an element or a compound or two compounds combine to form a single product, right? And the second type of reaction is decomposition reaction, where
single compound.
The single compound will split into either two simpler elements or an element and a compound or two compounds, right? We have discussed in the last class how to write these equations, how to know if it is carbonate, or first we have discussed if it is oxide. Any oxide upon decomposition, what we will get? Any compound on decomposition, what we will get? We'll get element and oxygen. Any metal or non-metal, upon decomposition, we will get respective metal and oxygen gas will be liberated. Second, we have discussed hydroxides. Hydroxides, when we decompose, hydroxides will form respective oxides and water vapor. They will release water. Did you all remember these reactions? Right, what is the next one we have discussed? Carbonates.
Carbonates,
they form metallic oxide and they release carbon dioxide gas. And we have also discussed nitrates. Nitrates, what do they release? What do nitrates decompose? Nitrates nitrogen upon decomposition, what you will get?
Nitrogen dioxide plus the oxide of the...
Yes. We'll get metallic oxide, nitrogen dioxide, and also oxygen gas will be liberated. Okay, so this is for metallic nitrates. So this is how you can write the decomposition reaction. Decomposition of oxides, it forms metal and oxygen gas. Decomposition of hydroxides, it forms metallic oxides and water will be released. Decomposition of carbonates, we'll get metallic oxide and carbon dioxide. Decomposition of nitrates, we will get metallic oxide, nitrogen dioxide, and oxygen. Is it clear?
And oxygen.
These are the four types of decomposition reactions which
ma'am,
you have. There are many.
Background.
Yes?
Ma'am, some background music is coming from Yashiraj, ma'am.
Yashiraj is a mute.
Ma'am, before it was coming, ma'am.
Okay. So is it clear, children? Did you understand? So these four examples are there for you in your textbook. Apart from that, if you take chlorides, I think now you all can write. Metallic chlorides upon decomposition, what do they release? Chlorides.
Metal plus chloride.
What do we get when metallic chlorides are decomposed? What do we get?
Salt.
Metallic chlorides. Chloride means, for example, NaCl. NaCl, what do we get?
Sodium and chlorine.
Very good. We'll get the element and the chlorine gas will be liberated. We'll get sodium plus chlorine gas. Are you able to follow? Any oxide will get element and oxygen gas. In the same way, chlorides, we will get element and the chlorine gas. Are you able to follow? Did you get this? Now, can you write or are you thorough with the decomposition reactions? Can you decompose when an element, when a compound is given? If you know what will be the products which are forming, it is easy for you to write the equations. Is it clear, children? Any doubt? Okay. So, Girija, are you able to understand? Yes, what are the four type of decomposition reactions?
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, Manas. What are the four different examples of decomposition reactions, not types? What are the examples we have discussed? First one is oxides. Any oxide will decompose into metal, element and oxygen. Second, decomposition of carbonates. Carbonates will decompose into metallic oxide, carbon dioxide. Next one, hydroxides. Hydroxides will decompose into metallic oxides and water will be liberated. In the same way, nitrates. These four are the examples. In exam, you'll get only examples upon these four. Am I clear? Right? Yes. Today, we'll see types of decomposition reactions. Types of decomposition. Are you all able to hear me, children? Are you all able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. Yes. So today we'll discuss types of decomposition reactions. Types of decomposition reactions means nothing but if we want to decompose a substance. Decomposition means, as we have discussed in the last class, if we want to break a substance, we have to supply some energy. Right? I think you all, we have discussed this in the previous class. Right? If we want to break any substance, we have to supply some energy. That energy may be in the form of heat, that energy may be in the form of light, and that energy may be in the form of electric current. So based upon the source through which we are supplying energy to get the decomposition reactions, we will get three types of decomposition reactions. So the types of decomposition reactions are based upon the source of energy which we are supplying. Are you able to understand? The three types of the decomposition reactions are thermal decomposition. Thermal decomposition means the decomposition which is brought by the supply of thermal means heat energy. Right? Next, photo decomposition reaction. Photo, what is meant by photons? Photo means
light.
So you can write the definition of photo decomposition reactions. It's very simple. The decomposition reaction which is brought through light energy, which undergoes in the presence of light energy. Next one is electric decomposition reaction. So Uttirna, tell me the definition of electric decomposition reaction. Uttirna, definition of electric decomposition reaction.
Ma'am, I did not understand thermal decomposition reaction.
Thermal means heat. The decomposition reaction which is brought by supplying of heat energy.
Heat.
Yes, Uttirna, okay. Tell me. Electric decomposition reaction. What will be the definition for that? Okay, Amay, are you there? Yes, Amay, are you there? Yes, tell me, what is electric decomposition reaction? Give the definition for that.
Ma'am, a reaction that occurs when an electric current applied solutions.
So the decomposition reactions which is brought by the supply of electric current is called as electric decomposition reactions. So for you in your chapter, you have to learn the examples of thermal decomposition reaction. First one, as we have discussed, thermal decomposition means the decomposition caused by heat is called as thermal decomposition. In the last class, we have discussed some examples. So nitrates, carbonates, hydroxides, whatever these decomposition reactions we have discussed, all these are examples of thermal decomposition reactions. I repeat, the reactions which we have discussed, the decomposition of nitrates, decomposition of carbonates, decomposition of hydroxides. So all these, from magnesium in the reactivity series, magnesium to calcium, the compounds, the salts of all these elements, they decompose in the presence of heat. Okay, and when they decompose, they form their respective oxides and releases the byproducts. If it is nitrates, it releases nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. If it is carbonate, it releases carbon dioxide. If it is hydroxide, it releases water. Whereas these two, silver and gold, maximum only gold cannot decompose. Generally silver, they are very weak. So they completely decompose into element and nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. In the same way, if we take silver carbonate, can you tell me the reaction what we will get? Yes, Ajay, tell me the reaction. If we take silver carbonate, what we will get?
We will get Au plus CO2 plus O2.
Yes, Ajay. What do we get if we take silver carbonate?
We'll get.
Let Ajay answer.
Silver carbonate, we will get silver. One second. Silver oxide and carbon dioxide.
Yes. So listen here. Silver, when any carbonate, nitrate, or hydroxide of silver decomposes, it does not form oxide. It directly form metal itself, because the carbonate, nitrate, hydroxides of silver and gold are very weak. So you just observe this slide. From magnesium to calcium, these elements, the nitrates, carbonates, hydroxides of these elements, when decomposed, they give oxides. Whereas silver and gold, they directly give the metal. They does not form oxides. Did you understand
this what statement?
Yes, Rohan.
Ma'am, what are the other products?
Other products will be same. Silver plus carbon dioxide.
Okay.
Okay. If we take hydroxide, what do we get? Of silver hydroxide, what do we get?
We will get silver and water.
Did you understand this statement? I repeat, silver and gold, when decomposed, they does not form oxides, but they form the metal itself. Clear? Ajay, did you get this? Okay, right. So the first type of reaction is thermal decomposition reaction, which is brought through the presence of heat. Okay, now there are two things here which you have to understand. Two terms are there. Thermal decomposition is there and thermal dissociation is also there. What is the difference between these two? I repeat, there are two terms. Thermal decomposition and thermal dissociation. Can anyone give the difference between these two?
Ma'am, may I?
Yes, Rohan.
thermal decomposition forms compounds and elements, whereas thermal dissociation forms ions.
Not ions, it forms simple elements. Okay, see here. If you take the example of, let us take the example of carbon dioxide. Okay, carbon dioxide, or let us take any oxide. For example, if we take the oxide of carbon dioxide, when we heat, it releases carbon monoxide. That means the compound will split into two elements. For example, HCl is there. HCl will break into hydrogen gas and chlorine gas. Okay, so the compound is dissociating into two elements. We call it as thermal dissociation, separation. Whereas if a compound is decomposing into a simpler compound, for example, if you take calcium carbonate, it is not dissociating into two parts. It is dissociating into simpler compounds, calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So if a compound upon decomposition, if it gives simpler compounds, it is called as thermal decomposition. If it completely breaks, that means it dissociates into two elements, we call it as thermal dissociation. Is it clear? Okay, just understand the terms thermal decomposition, which differs from thermal dissociation. Clear? Next, coming to the second type of decomposition reactions is photodecomposition reactions. As we have discussed, the decomposition reaction caused by light is called as photodecomposition reactions. So all the metallic chlorides, which the reaction does generally happen in the presence of sunlight. So they are so weak, as we have discussed, the least reactive metals, if they form compounds, they are so weak that they, just by supply of sun, in the presence of sunlight only, they will
excuse
decompose.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Toshit.
Excuse me, ma'am. Is it that photodecomposition reaction only happen with halogens, because chlorine and bromine all are halogens?
Generally, we take this example. Okay, these are the examples mentioned in your textbook. There are many other photodecomposition reactions. So all the photodecomposition reactions takes place in organic compounds and in least reactive metals. I repeat, photodecomposition reaction decomposes the least reactive metals. The compounds of least reactive metals will be decomposed in the presence of sunlight. So we'll take the example of silver, we'll take copper also, we'll take something. Copper also undergoes photodecomposition. Is it clear? So only these examples are there for you in your textbook. The silver halides will dissociate in the presence of sunlight into silver and respective halogens. Next, coming to electrolytic decomposition or electric decomposition. Electric decomposition is caused due to electric current. Okay, so electric decomposition is generally done in the compounds which are very stable. Very stable compound means the most reactive elements. For example, if we take sodium chloride, if we take potassium chloride, we know what are the most reactive metals. What are the most reactive metals?
Sodium, potassium.
Sodium, potassium and magnesium, right? These are the most. Okay. These are the most reactive metals. So most reactive metals, they form stable compounds. I repeat, most reactive metals form stable compounds. If they form stable compounds, in order to decompose them, we have to supply more energy. Do you all agree that if the compound is stable, it is not easy to decompose the substance? Do you all agree with that? Did you understand that one? Right? If the compound is very stable, we cannot simply break it out. We cannot simply decompose. We have to supply large amount of energy. So in such cases, heat energy and sunlight are not sufficient. So we will use electric current in order to decompose such compounds. So the stable compounds can be decomposed only in the presence of electric current. Such type of decomposition reactions are called as electric decomposition reactions. These two examples, for example, sodium chloride and water, these are mentioned in your textbook. Yes, Samiksha? Are you able to follow, children? Right? So, least reactive metal compounds can be decomposed just by using sunlight. The elements which are in the middle of the reactivity series can be decomposed using heat. Whereas most reactive metallic compounds can be decomposed using electric current. Did you understand these three differences, three types of reactions where we use? Okay, in which elements do we use thermal decomposition reaction? Aishwarya, which case we will use thermal decomposition reactions?
Ma'am, can you please show the slide of photo decomposition reaction
properly?
Yes, Aishwarya, where we will use thermal decomposition?
Ma'am, I'm not able to hear you properly.
You're not able to hear me?
Okay,
I repeat, in the metallic
series. Can you show the pre-made?
Yes, in the activity series, we can classify all the metals as most reactive, less reactive, and least reactive. Less reactive means generally they are intermediate elements, right? These magnesium to calcium, they are intermediate reactivity. The reactivity is less. So potassium, calcium and potassium and sodium are most reactive metals. So if we want to decompose the salts, the compounds of most reactive metals, we will use electric current, that is electric decomposition. If we want to decompose the least reactive metals, we can just decompose by supplying sunlight. In the presence of sunlight also they decompose. The elements which are intermediate, if we want to decompose these, the compounds of these elements, we have to supply heat. Did you understand this one? If you understand the statement, completing the reactions is very easy. They will give you one compound and they'll ask you which type of decomposition. So you have to see the position in the activity series. If it is least reactive, which decomposition reaction will be used? Yes, Advut, if it is least reactive, which type of decomposition we will do? Tell again.
Thermal decomposition reaction.
If it is least reactive, we will do photo decomposition. Photo decomposition is less than heat. Okay, the heat supplied by sunlight is less when compared to the thermal heat which we supply. Generally, thermal decomposition means we will supply from 200 degrees Celsius, 300 degrees Celsius, like that. Thermal means, don't think it is 70, 80 degrees Celsius. Okay, 300, 200, we'll sometimes 500, 800. Yes. Yes.
Ma'am, will they give the metal reactivity? Will they give the metal reactivity series?
They will not ask you to write the metal reactivity series. It is in 8th standard. Now they'll just give you to complete the reactions.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. So these three types of decomposition reactions, we can understand which type of decomposition is required. Whether heat, that is thermal decomposition, or is it just by sunlight, or do we require more energy, that is electric energy? Do we require more energy? So this, which type of decomposition reaction is employed, we can understand by the position of metal in the reactivity series. The compounds of least reactive metals can be decomposed by using sunlight, which is photo decomposition. The metals, the compounds of the metals which are most reactive, highly reactive metals, those compounds we can decompose using electric current. Whereas the intermediate reactivity, the compounds of intermediate reactivity elements can be decomposed using heat, that is thermal decomposition. Is it clear, children? Did you understand? Okay. And
yes,
electric decomposition reaction, please remember this one. Electric decomposition reaction is also called as electrolysis. Electrolysis, we will say. Lysis means, what is lysis? Lysing means breaking. Breaking a molecule using electric current is called as electrolysis. We will use the term hydrolysis. Hydrolysis. Mm-hmm. What is meant by hydrolysis? Hydrolysis means, lysing means breaking. Breaking a molecule using water is called as hydrolysis. Photolysis. What is meant by photolysis?
Photolysis is the photolysis means breaking, right?
Breaking the molecule using sunlight is photolysis. In the same way, electrolysis is breaking, that is decomposing a molecule using electric current. Clear? This is all about decomposition reactions. So in the next class, we will discuss displacement reaction. Now I'll leave you as you will be having your geography class. Children, before leaving, just in the chat box,
thank you, ma'am.
Mention all those who are present. Just mention as present. There is no time to take the attendance. I don't want to waste the time for that. Just write in the chat box who all are present. Just write present, ma'am. Then I can get note down your attendance. Any doubt? Did you understand decomposition reaction? Is it clear? Yes, any doubt, children?
No, ma'am.
Okay, you can mention as present and you can leave the class.
Ma'am, which meeting I need to use?
Yes, Chester.
Ma'am, which meeting ID do we have to use?
Sorry?
Ma'am, which meeting ID do we have to use for geography class? The one which
you
is shared?
You got the invite, no? You got the invite, something about...
the one which is shared, right?
Ma'am has sent the invite.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Goodbye.
Ma'am, bye, Manas.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Yeah, bye. Yes, Ashraj, any doubt? Did you mark present?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine.